All right, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Brevard Sports Network and our continuing coverage of Pop Warner action. It's Championship Saturday here live from the campus of Vieira High School as we have the Eastern Coast Conference championships all day right here on the Brevard Sports Network. Starting off with 6U action between the Port Orange Hawks and the Suntree Vieira Hawks. Caleb Brown here will be here with you all day long as we get ready for 6U action. Let us know. Here we go. 6U action. Championship Saturday. I am so excited to be here with you guys. Look, this is where you see the bid for nationals begins. It truthfully starts 2 weeks ago at the start of playoff action. But this right here, this is where the true journey begins. Championship Saturday. I'm going to be here with you. All right, here we go. All clear on the weather. That's awesome. The white and orange are the Port Orange, and the gray with the pink socks. And Port Orange will be start off with the ball first here on offense. I'd like to thank our sponsor, Space Coast Resurfacing. Why rip it out when you can just resurface it? Give them a call at 321-652-1103. And pressure coming right off that backside. Again, that Suntree Vieira Hawks defense coming out and making a play. It's a Nazari on the tackle. It's going to bring up 2nd and 12 here for the Port Orange Hawks. Trying to get to the outside and bada boom. That Suntree Vieira Hawk. That's going to be Dominic Barbado. And Max DeGraff was also in there causing disruption. 3rd and long for Port Orange. Trying to get to the outside and breaks a tackle, tries to cut backfield, but guess what? There's another Hawk defender right there waiting for him. And that's Max DeGraff who comes and cleans up that tackle. 4th and really long here for the Port Orange Hawks. Here on Championship Saturday.
And here we go, back again. He's got some running room. Coach has changed his direction, and he's tackled just towards the line of scrimmage.
And He gets back to the line of scrimmage. Turnover on downs, and it's first and 10 for the SunTree Vieira Hawks. And so we'll get a chance to see this SunTree Vieira Hawks offense in action. As Space Coast resurfacing, respotting of the ball. And it will be placed on the 35-yard line. Left to go here in the first quarter. SunTree Vieira comes out. Two backs in the backfield. As so I'll be honest, I don't understand why the referees had to move the ball to the 35, but so that doesn't make sense. What's the point of getting the stop on defense? Okay, so even though it's a fourth and, you know, turnover on downs, it gets moved back to the 35-yard line. Don't understand that one. Parquette under center. Parquette right up the middle, and Osiris Parquette picks up a gain of
23, the ball carrier. That was Bryson Wright.
Oh, wait, 23?
Second and about three now for the Vieira Hawks as they try to mount a drive here in this championship game.
It's 6-0. Okay. I believe you. I've never seen it happen this season was all. Once again, Osiris Parquette continuing to pick up first downs for the SunTree Vieira Hawks.
I'll say number 23 is Osiris Parquette. Oh.
And Parquette continuing to push this pile forward. And that'll be a gain of about 4 yards on the play.
All right.
Let us know where you're watching from and who you're cheering on here on the Brevard Sports Network. We're going to have coverage for you all day long.
All right, second and about six now.
Second and six for the SVYFL Hawks. And Parquette will pick up another first down. Parquette is just putting the team on his shoulders, saying, hey. Oh, wow. Okay, so they're going to mark him short. And Parquette again pushing his way through. And that's going to move the change for a SunTree Vieira Hawk first down as Parquette continuously.
All right, Parquette was the ball carrier.
Cash money number 22 for the Port Orange Hawks. 3:48 left to go here in the scoreless first quarter. But the Century Vieira Hawks are moving the ball efficiently on the legs of Osiris Parkett. Like to thank Space Coast Resurfacing. You can count on Space Coast Resurfacing to not only meet but exceed all your needs and requests. Learn more about the services Space Coast Resurfacing offers by checking out their website at www.spacecoastresurfacing.com. Why rip it out when you can just resurface it and turn it in, turn that bathroom or kitchen into the area that you can be proud of. Parkett getting stuffed at the line, falls forward for a gain of about four. Second and six here for the Hawks of Century Vieira. Listen, this 6U Hawks team, they have other weapons. I mean, currently they're using, you know, Osiris Parkett to move the football, but they have lots of other weapons. Bryson Wright, Dominic Barbado, Rowan Goff. Plethora of weapons.
All right, flags are on the play. There may have been a little bit of movement, and yes, there was. It's going to go against Vieira, moving them back five.
And false start for Suntry Vieira. That'll back him up 5 yards. ECC playoff or ECC championship Saturday right here on the Brevard Sports Network. Watching from Erie, PA, go Dominic Barbado. Parkett under center. Takes a snap, Parkett, out around the left side, cuts back inside, cuts across the field, and is brought down. He'll pick up. Got about to the 17-yard line as they are inside the Space Coast Resurfacing red zone. Inside, like I said, about the 18 or 17 yard line. Remember, shorter field for 6U.
Third down, and here we go back up to the line of scrimmage. The Arrowhawks are trying to mount a drive here. Somebody has got to put some digits on the board.
Sends in motion there, number 15, Kane Wallace. And Parkett's going to take it himself. Parkett right here around the left side. Makes a man miss. Can't make the next man miss. And the Port Orange Hawks. The Port Orange Hawks come up with a nice stop. It's going to bring up fourth down for Suntry Vieira. And number 22, Cash Szymanski, in on the tackle. And Parkett, dragging defenders, and he'll pick himself up a first down. Osiris Parkett continuing to carry the Hawks on his back. Yes, it is.
All right. Osiris was the man with the plan on that one as he ran it right up the side. Nifty little run right there. And it's going to move the chain.
Watching from something Berg, New York. I can't pronounce that. Brett Abbey watching number 11 for Suntry Vieira, Kevin Abbey.
And Vieira is up to the line of scrimmage.
Parkett again.
We are knocking it down, 47
First and 10, and here comes around the left side. Makes a man miss. Slips through another couple tackles. And it's going to bring up second and goal. And checking into the game is going to be number 13, Nazir McDonald. He's another weapon this Hawks team has, so keep an eye out for him. Second and goal from about the 8 or 9 yard line. Lots of motion. Parkett keeps it himself. Parkett will be taken down at about the 5 yard line. And that will be the end of the first quarter with your score. 0-0. We'll be right back. And again, we'd like to thank our sponsors. Thank you to a sponsor for stepping up. Space Coast Resurfacing and American Air and Plumbing. Two sponsors stepping up tonight. And we'll be right back. All right, second quarter action happening right here on the Brevard Sports Network. Fresh set of digits are up on the clock as we speak. 0-0 is our score. You're watching this 2023 East Coast Conference Championship. ECC Championship, second quarter set to begin. And again, we are inside the 5 yard line. Third and goal for SunTree Vieira Hawks.
And once again, Vieira is knocking at the door. We're going to continue this second quarter of regulation play.
That's McDonald, Nazir McDonald. I believe that was number 12 on the tackle for Port Orange.
And that was Tyson Connor.
Tyson Connor on the tackle for Port Orange. And it's going to bring up fourth and goal for SunTree Vieira. Here we go, fourth and goal. Parkett, and there was motion. Wait a minute, that's going to be on encroachment on the defense. That's going to be half the distance. So it. It's going to be a half the distance down to about the 2 yard line. They just got 2 yards to go, and personally, I know what I'm calling here. Osiris Parkett up the middle. You've been getting at least 3 to 4 yards on that push every time, just like the Philadelphia Eagles. I say you go right back up the middle with it. But that's just me. Parkett tries to go outside, pushing forward, and he's in! Touchdown, SunTree Vieira! Osiris Parkett.
No flags on the play, so that one's going to stick. Parkett was the first one to draw first blood on this one. And 6-0 is your score. Let's see what they do here with this extra point.
Time to see the extra point here. Osiris Parkett gets into the end zone. Look, I mean, having him going around the outside is not a horrible call either.
And
And that's DeGraff. They tried handing it to DeGraff on the end around. Extra point, no good, but it's the Suntree Vieira Hawks. Pick up points. And they take the lead 6-0 here in the ECC 6U Championship. And again, I'd like to thank our sponsor there, Space Coast Resurfacing. We also like to bring in our other sponsor. And our other sponsor is... It's American Air and Plumbing. Where is their bottom banner? There it is. American Air and Plumbing, sponsor of the BSN Florida Tough Player of the Month. The Port Orange Hawks. Jackie Maldonado, go Parkette. Watching from San Antonio, Texas. And there's a nice run there by the quarterback of Port Orange, and that should be enough. Now, Suntree Vieira says they got the football. It's going to be a first down for the Port Orange Hawks. I didn't catch the number of that quarterback. I think it might have been number 12, I think. But I don't have a 12. Oh, Tyson Connor, I believe, was the ball carrier. There's number 3 on the pass, and it's incomplete. That is cut. Kyrie Wells was the quarterback in that threw the incomplete pass. Apologize, I'm bouncing back and forth between the roster and the broadcast. I believe that's Tyson Connor. Tyson Connor down the sideline. Tyson Connor taken down at about the 10-yard line. And what a play there by Connor. Check that, Cade Wallace, the ball carrier. That's going to go bye-bye. We don't take those spammers on our page. Get off. Bye-bye. But first and goal inside the 10-yard line for Port Orange.
First and goal to go now for the Port Orange Hawks, 6U. This is a 6U matchup right here for the...
Kyrie Wells under center. Wells looking, and he'll be hit immediately, falling forward for a couple of yards. They'll give him officially 1 yard on the fall down. It's going to bring up second and goal from the 9. Folks, let me know at home if the stream is freezing up on you. Pressure comes. I think it was 11. Kevin Abbey with the... Again, let me know if the stream is glitching for you folks at home. If it is, I'll move it to the straight Facebook Live, but it's going to bring up fourth and goal from about the 13-yard line. Port Orange. And boom, the Hawks defense comes up with a stop. Suntree Vieira comes up with the stop, led by number 99, Max DeGraff. Turnover on downs for the Hawks as Suntree Vieira will take over first and 10. And here we go. Get the second possession of the Suntree Vieira Hawks. 3:55 left to go here in the second quarter. And here we go. Back up to the line of scrimmage where the Hawks have the ball first and 10 from the 35-yard line. There's the handoff right up the middle, and he'll make his way to the 50-yard line. Check that. That was from the 45-yard line, so second and five. All right. Like I said, just let me know if it's skipping, if it keeps skipping, because if I need to switch to straight Facebook Live, I will. Third and a yard for three eleven here in the first half left. Parkett, third down. Parkett continuing to pick up big first downs for the Hawks. First and 10 on the 42-yard line of Port Orange. Parkett turns around to make sure he gets the correct call from the coach. Parkett going right up the middle, and Parkett continuing to push the pile, gets a gain of about 8 yards on the play. Osiris Parkett continuing to just put the team on his back. All that motion, and then boom. He's hitting that A gap, he's hitting that B gap, and just powering through. And Parquette continuing to make people miss. Parquette down the sideline into the end zone. Touchdown, Suntree Vieira.
No flags are on the play, so that one will stick.
No flags. 1:46 left before the half. And Osiris Parquette with a 20-plus yard touchdown run. Extra point denied as Nazir McDonald. Tyson Connor with the stop. And it will be turnover on downs here. It'll be a score for Suntree Vieira. And it's 12-0. I don't know why I said turnover on downs. Just a point after touchdown denied by Tyson Connor. And the Hawks need to get something here, does Port Orange, because Port Orange is just... They had a drive and were stuffed in the red zone. Penalties kept that one from getting in. Wells hands off to number five. Number five cuts up the field. But there are flags on the play. That was number five on the carry. Amir Lee on the ball carry. And Port Orange has life as a penalty was called on the Hawks. Like to thank American Air and Plumbing for stepping up and being a sponsor, as well as Space Coast Resurfacing. All these games will be right here on the Brevard Sports Network all day long. We're currently working with Flagler to get the 10 and 12 U games broadcasted. And once again, now that you're getting to that American Air and Plumbing red zone, this Hawks team, we've found out in between the 40s, you can move the ball on them a little bit. As soon as you hit that red zone, they're a wall and they're ready to make something happen. Osiris Parquette. 1 minute left here before the half. It's going to bring up third and about 13 for Port Orange. Got Asa Jones watching. I'm sure she's waiting for that Satellite Beach Youth Scorpions. We'll have the 8U and 11U matchups coming up here today. We'll also have the 14U matchup. We're working with Flagler, and once again, that Hawks defense comes in and just bam. And timeout called by Suntree Vieira with 43 seconds left to go in the half. And Suntree Vieira is trying to keep time on the clock. They want to go put another score on the board before halftime. but it comes first. They got to get the defensive stop. Port Orange has shown capabilities to have a big play, but just not able to punch it into the red zone. Can they make that mistake, or can they correct that mistake here? Or will the SunTree Vieira Hawk defense come up with the play? Back to action here. Fourth and long. 43 seconds left to go here in the half. Port Orange with the ball. Looking for something big here. Port Orange has got to get to the 9-yard line to pick up a first down. Currently they're sitting on the Currently, they're sitting at the 25.
Folks, don't forget there's a flag on the play right now. But there is a sign up there by the entrance with the 2023 East Coast Conference Championships. It's a great photo opportunity. If you would like to come up and take pictures by it, it's perfect. Right there by the front.
And flag is on the play, and that's going to be an unsportsmanlike conduct on Port Orange.
And there's an unsportsman call. Going to be fourth and long now for the Hawks. Port Orange is right back at the 50-yard line.
Port Orange backed up to the 50-yard line. They got to get to the 9 in order to make something happen and keep this drive alive. Still 43 seconds left to go here in the game, or in the half. And so another penalty that one's going to be on SunTree Vieira. It's going to be fourth down. Port Orange still trying to keep this drive alive. It's another fourth down. And there's number 12. More flags on the play. False start against the Hawks. All right, number 13 looks to be the quarterback. 13 falls forward and that'll be a stop on fourth down with 12 seconds left. 13 on the run. That's Kristen Miller who got stopped. And with 12 seconds left to go here in the half, the SunTree Vieira Hawks have another opportunity to put points on the board. All right, folks, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to switch over to a straight Facebook Live because it looks like for some reason we're having issues with the program. So coming up at halftime, I'll switch over to straight Facebook Live, and we will go from there.
line of scrimmage right now, first and 10.
And pressure coming right up the middle. And timeout called by Suntree Vier with 8 seconds left. So Suntree Vier. Comes up to parquet.
All right, back to the line of scrimmage, the Vieira Hawks. Just at the 40-yard line. 8 seconds left to go before the half.
Parquet under center. Parquet not able to get the snap off.
And pressure coming his way. Fort Orange Hawks bring that one in there as well. It appears that Mr. Skamansky was the ball in there on the tackle.
False start.
Fort Orange Hawks. And that's going to be a false start. And it's moving them back five. And we have one untimed down as a result of that.
Wait, okay, so you have the team walking off. There is all sorts of confusion going on the field at the moment. And we have an untimed down. You have a coaches pulling players off now, trying to rush players back on. And there's Parquet. Parquet with an opportunity. Osiris Parquet slips the tackle down the sideline. Osiris Parquet, touchdown, Suntree Vier. There's a down Port Orange Hawk, but with no time left to go here in the second quarter, 18-0 is your score as the Hawk is up and walking off under his own power. No, I will be uploading all these videos to YouTube after they're all done. And again, I'm going to be switching over to a Facebook Live because it looks like my program is running slow, and extra point is good. It's Nazir McDonald in on the extra point. And we are at halftime. We're going to change streams here, folks, and head to a Facebook live stream so we can make sure we can do this with no more interruptions. Your score is 19-0, Suntree Vier on top. All right, folks, we're sorry about that. We had to reset everything. All right, folks. Here we go. right. I think we're good. All right, folks. Again, I apologize. I apologize for all this. So the way the stadium is set up, the sun is coming in and hitting our equipment, which is causing the battery to heat up. Battery heats up, obviously it slows the phone down, and we can't use our program with the scoreboard and the fancy graphics. So we're going to go to a straight Facebook Live because we want to make sure we bring all these games to you in their entirety. I do apologize again. Sometimes, you know, technology can only handle so much. And starting to get to that steamy Florida day. So all these games. All right, so again, we'd like to thank our sponsors who are making this happen. We'd like to thank American Air and Plumbing. American Air and Plumbing, Brevard's go-to pros for Florida tough AC and plumbing services, and proud sponsors of the Brevard Sports Network, Florida Tough Player of the Month. Trust American Air and Plumbing for fast AC repairs and rugged AC systems like their Florida edition, built to withstand the brutal Florida climate, or the revolutionary Daikin AC, with rebates up to $1,800 and warranties up to 12 years. Serving Brevard since 1942, visit them online at www.AmericanAirAndPlumbing.com or give them a call at 321-632-2653. Again, re-tag all your friends. Let them know that this is where they can watch the remainder of the 6U game. And to answer a viewer who said there wasn't a penalty on the last play, yes, there was a penalty called on Port Orange, or it was called on Vieira. It was a false start for Suntree Vieira. So because of that penalty, they got one untimed down, and that's how they scored. Score is 19-0. I'll put that here in the comments. 19-0, we're here at halftime. So, got about 47 seconds left here of halftime. And, again, I apologize. Sometimes when you're doing live production, things happen and equipment gets heated. And because the equipment got heated, we can't use our fancy program with the graphics and the scoreboard and all that. So I will tell you of the score. I'll tell you the score and time about every minute and a half, 2 minutes. Coming up here in the second half, you will know score. You will know how much time is left. Again, if you're on your way over, I'll let fans know if you're on your way over to hit the 14U or either the other games, there is no re-entry. So once you buy a ticket, there's no re-entry.
So we're about to get this back underway. 19-0 is your score.
19-0 is your score as these squads get set for second half action. Right here on the Brevard Sports Network.
Now we got more football still coming your way, so if you're just arriving, we'd like to welcome you to this Vieira High School field. Great accommodation.
Live from the campus of Vieira High School, the Hawk's Nest.
Next, the Satellite Scorpions will be doing their thing with the Deltona Panthers.
Treasure Coast is the site location. So Treasure Coast will be the site of regional action. So there you go. Huh? Yep. Hey, I'm letting people know now. I appreciate it. Can't wait for the next game. You got Chris Dennison. Can't wait for the next game. I am ready for the Trent Brundage show. All right, so we got another minute left here in halftime. And, folks, we got some great football on tap all day today. We also got playoff volleyball. Yes, we even have high school playoff volleyball on the Brevard Sports Network. Alan Slaughter-Zinski will go be broadcasting the Merritt Island Mustangs as they continue their quest towards Winter Haven. Also, one of the other teams playing today will be the Vieira Hawks. They'll be playing. That game will not be on the Brevard Sports Network. We didn't have anyone step up to sponsor that playoff game. But someone from Merritt Islands came to us early this week and said, hey, we want that volleyball game, playoff game. And so, and again, we'd like to thank the ECC. The ECC granted us permission and have done an excellent job trying to take care of us and getting us ready for today's action. I'd like to thank Ron Ramsey, who also helped set it up. Ron Ramsey talked to the ECC on our behalf and got permission for us to broadcast all these games. ECC Championship Saturday right here on the Brevard Sports Network. And here we go. We're ready set to begin the second half. Fresh eight on the clock, 19-0. Okay, I didn't even see the snap. That's McDonald. McDonald fighting, trying to get back to the line of scrimmage. I don't think anybody knew the play had really begun. Second and 10 for the SunTree Vieira Hawks here. First possession of the second half. 7:26 left to go here in the third quarter. Parkett. Harbor Creek, PA. Got Johnny Arroyo watching. And McDonald, again, not able to find any running room, gets dropped in the backfield. They'll give him forward progression on a yard. It's going to bring up 3rd and 9. Szymanski comes in. Chris Dennison, that's funny. I'm sure these coaches would agree with you. Six U action right here on the Brevard Sports Network. Under center and missed tackle. That's McDonald. Nazir McDonald picks up a nice chunk of yards. Going to bring up 4th and short for the SunTree Vieira Hawks. And Madara Rumble, thank you very much for the kind words. We love being able to give these kids the platform that these kids deserve. And I mean that for all, whether we're talking Brevard County or non-Brevard County, these kids deserve a platform to show off their skills. And we're happy to be able to provide that platform here on Championship Saturday. McDonald, the quarterback. McDonald going around the right side. Nazir McDonald slips the tackle. He's got a first down and more. He's going, dragging defenders, and finally brought down inside the 15-yard line. And if you are a Flagler, a fan of the Flagler program, they're promoting the food trucks here, and I'm not gonna lie, it sounds fantastic. All of it does. Phoenix, Arizona. 5:31 left to go here in the third quarter. 19-0 Suntree, Vieira on top. They are inside the Space Coast Resurfacing red zone. Space Coast Resurfacing. McDonald in at quarterback. McDonald coming around the left side. Getting pulled by the hair. Dragging people by his hair. It's going to be second down and close to 4 yards. They're on the 12-yard line. They got to get to the 8. And look at McDonald slips through, dishing out a stiff arm, and he'll pick up the first down. It's first and goal for Suntree Vieira. McDonald around the right side, cuts, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Suntree Vieira. Nazir McDonald drive. 4:56 left to go here in the third quarter. Hold up, I will get you what teams are up next, because they're right here in our description. It will be the 8U Deltona Panthers and Satellite Beach. The Deltona Panthers and the Satellite Beach Youth Scorpions. And coach is not happy about something for Port Orange.
All right, folks, just keep in mind that the winner of these games today will be playing in the first round of regionals at Treasure Coast.
McDonald hands off on the end around, and it's in. Point after is good. Here, SBYFL on top. 26-0 is your score. There's a handoff there to number 10. Number 10. A horde of Hawks coming through and making that play happen. Second and 15 for Port Orange. Again, I'd like to thank the Flagler Titans Youth Football. There's balls on the ground. Believe the Flagler Titans have stepped up and have stepped up. The organization has stepped up to make sure that the 10 and 12 U games are also going to be shown right here on the Brevard Sports Network. So go ahead and let all the friends and family know that you'll be able to see every game right here on the Brevard Sports Network. Every game. Encroachment on Suntry Vieira. Third and 9 for Port Orange. 3:23 left to go here in. Nope, there should be no glitches. We're on a straight Facebook Live. Ah, here we go. And that's going to be a false start. Hey, he was ready. He was ready to be a lead blocker and take his guy to the promised land. A little too ready, but ready nonetheless. I'd like to thank American Air and Plumbing and Space Coast Resurfacing. Tell you about them in the next stoppage of play. And off, and the ball is on the ground dead.
That's a dead ball right there.
Fourth and 14 for Port Orange. And unfortunately for them, they haven't been able to get much of anything going. They had one sustained drive there at the end of the first half, and then they got stopped in the red zone. And that's nothing to hang your head about. This defense has been absolutely stout when it comes to red zone play this season. And he is bottled up in the backfield. He's running backwards. Makes a man miss and taken down on an arm tackle. Number 13. That's what it looked like to me. And it's a turnover on downs. It was number 13 on the ball carry. Kristen Miller. 1:54 left to go here in the third quarter. 26-0. Suntry Vieira on top. And Suntry Vieira will get the ball at the 45-yard line. Or 35, sorry. 35-yard line for Suntry Vieira, first and 10. Delay of game on Suntry Vieira.
It's going to go against the Vieira Hawks. first and 15 for the Vieira Hawks.
First and 15 for the Hawks. There's number seven. That's Dominic Barbato. Barbato on the spin move. Falls forward and picks up a positive gain there. That was number seven, Dominic Barbato, on the carry. Now, folks, if you hear me repeating something several times, I want to make sure the... gets just past the original line of scrimmage. But there was a holding penalty, I believe. If you hear me repeating these multiple times, I'm trying to help out the PA announcer. We're a team here, and we're trying to make sure each other knows what's going on. And he's helped me plenty of times. So exactly. Look, so if you hear me repeat something multiple times, I'm not trying to, you know, sound like a broken record. I'm just making sure my PA guy is on the same page as me. And there he goes. He's got himself close back to the original line of scrimmage. That's Dominic Barbato again.
Barbato was the ball carrier, and he was tote the rock on that play.
It'll bring up second and 11.
Second and about 11 now as he brings it back up. Let's see what he does here. 59 seconds, and the clock is
59 and counting left to go here in the third quarter. You're watching the 2023 East Coast Conference Championship. Fumble on the play. That's going to bring up third, and they might lose a yard there. And there's an injured Hawk. As Brevard County represented well today here at the Eastern Coast Conference Championships, ECC. We got two teams from Suntree Vieira. We got two teams from Satellite Beach. I believe we have three teams from Flagler. I know that's not Brevard County, but
play is in motion.
And Barbato continuing to fight forward for yards. It's going to bring up fourth down and about four. Fourth and four for Suntree Vieira. Well, and there. Wait a minute. Penalty on Suntree Vieira. Oh, no, they're switching sides. That was the end of the third quarter. I'm so used to hearing the horn. There was no horn to signal the end of the quarter. I was like, "Wait a minute." I'm like, did Suntree Vieira get a penalty? No. And here we go. Fourth and about four for Suntree Vieira. Barbato has been the primary ball carrier this drive. Fresh eight on the clock. Fourth quarter set to begin. 26-0, like to think Space Coast resurfacing. And they're going to give it off, and it's a fumble in the backfield. That'll be a turnover on downs. And it'll be first and 10 for Port Orange after the turnover on downs. Connor Tyson provided the pressure.
And it's going to be turnover on downs as the Port Orange Hawks take
7:55 left to go in the game. And once again, that SunTrevere Hawks defense makes a play. That was number three on the carry for Port Orange. It's Wells, I believe it is. Kyiri Wells. .7:30 left to go here in the game as... Second and 10 for the Port Orange Hawks. Wells hands off to number five. Number five cuts through. And number five loses the football. And we'll see. Suntry says they have it. Amir Lee and Port Orange will pick up the first down. Port Orange trying to get points on the board. 7 minutes left to go here in the game. Port Orange, again, we've seen two drives where Port Orange has been able to put a drive together, just not able to cap it off with the score. Amir Lee. And there's the Wells. Wells down the sideline and brought down inside the Space Coast resurfacing red zone. I'm going to thank Space Coast Resurfacing and American Air and Plumbing.
And here we go. Play is in motion, but it is going to be a false start. Movement that was on the line. It's going to move the Port Orange Hawks back five.
False start by Port Orange. That's going to back them up 5 yards. There's the handoff and trying to go on the end around and tracked down from behind by Osiris Parkett on the tackle. Miller on the carry. .5:26 left to go in the game. There's number 18 on the carry. He breaks away from a tackle. Can't break away from Osiris Parkett. Brantley Warner. There's run to the outside and brought down there by number five. And that's Bryson Wright on the tackle. .4:23 left to go in the game. And it looks like the Suntree Vieira Hawks will be moving on to Treasure Coast in the first round of regionals next week. They're playing at Treasure Coast. That's where regionals are being held at. There's number five. That's Amari Lee. Amari Lee. Oh, yeah. Amir Lee. Check that. And that's going to be a first down for Port Orange as they are inside the Space Coast resurfacing red zone. Water break coming up. And while we have a water break, I'd like to tell you about Space Coast Resurfacing. Space Coast Resurfacing, hold up. Da-da-da-da-da. You can count on Space Coast Resurfacing to not only meet but exceed all your needs and requests. Learn more about the services Space Coast Resurfacing offers by checking them out on their beautiful website at www.spacecoastresurfacing.com. Kitchen and bath remodeling without the destruction? What? Why rip it out when you can just resurface it? Call for your free estimate today at 321-652-1103 or find them online at www.spacecoastresurfacing.com. I'd like to thank Space Coast Resurfacing for stepping up and fires, and it's caught! It was a. It looked like it was a touchdown. Touchdown stands. So touchdown, Port Orange. We will have the trophy presentation. We will broadcast that trophy presentation live here on the Brevard Sports Network. Point after is good, or point after is no good. We will see the Titans coming up in, I believe, the next game. Hold up. Make sure. Nope. Not the next game. Next time you'll see the Titans will come up in the 10U game. The Flagler Titans organization has stepped up to get the sponsorship, so we will be broadcasting that game, both the 10 and 12U, even though there's no Brevard County teams. The organization has stepped up, so they want to broadcast it. They stepped up and got the sponsorship. So there we go. Every game will be broadcasted right here live on the Brevard Sports Network today. As it's 26-6, 3:44 left to go here in this 6U ECC Championship game. Suntree Vieira comes right back around. That's number 44. That's going to be Bryson Holland on the ball carry. Szymanski in there on the tackle. Second and three for Suntree Vieira. And that's Holland. Holland bowling his way through. Szymanski again on the tackle. But Bryson Holland continuing to move the football. Bryson Holland, the ball carrier for the Vieira Hawks. 2:59 left to go in the game. We are in just outside the red zone. Holland brought down at the 25-yard line. Cash Szymanski continue. Listen, if there's one thing I can take away from Port Orange, Cash Szymanski is going to be a name you guys are going to want to get familiar with. And as much as we love watching Port Orange come play Suntree Vieira, I know I'll be calling that young man's last name for at least the next, you know, 4 or 5 years, because he is good. Cash Szymanski. I apologize. Choking up on my own words here. But he's been a fun player to watch today. Holland cuts back upfield. Holland's got running room. Holland dragging a defender and finally brought down. It's a turnover, though, and Port Orange will get another crack at it. First and 10 for the Port Orange Hawks as the Port Orange Hawks are trying to. It's 26-6. Suntree Vieira will be moving on to the first round of regionals. That'll be next week in Treasure Coast. Oh, they don't move on? Okay. So check that. 6U does not advance. This is the last game of the season for 6U. So, what a way to cap off the season. 6U does not move on. 6U just stays. They end their season at the ECC Championship. There's the handoff around the outside. He's got room. And he will be brought down by number 16. McCoy Goodwin. Kristen Miller was the ball carrier for Port Orange. Number 16, McCoy Goodwin. So it's 26. Oh, my gosh, puts him on a spin cycle. They're leading the charge was number 44, Bryson Holland, led the charge for the Hawks. A minute 46 left. So the Suntree Vieira Hawks will end their season with a championship. And a sack. I can't see. It that might have been number 99, DeGraff. And it looks like we have a young man injured on the field. There's a young man on the field. Back up on his feet, and he will walk off the field. That was Kevin Abbey. Able to walk off under his own power. 1:15 left to go here in the game. Coming up next, 8U action. It's the Satellite Beach Youth Scorpions. And they will be taking on the Deltona Panthers.
Apologize about that. Trying to breathe. Breathing is quite nice, actually. 43 seconds left till Suntory Vieira will be hoisting a trophy. What a way to end their season. First and 10, turnover on downs. So, theoretically, I mean, a kneel down should be suffice. Okay, I'd like to thank both sponsors, American Air and Plumbing and Space Coast Resurfing. And the kneel down, and that'll do it, folks. The Suntory Vieira Hawks pick up an ECC championship win to end their season. Your 2023 ECC champions, the Suntory Vieira Hawks, will end their season with a trophy going in the trophy case. In just a few moments, we will have the trophy presentation right here on the Brevard Sports Network. Great game here. Port Orange always become a little rivalry with Suntory Vieira, and hats off to them for making it to the championship game. And may they have a safe trip home. And again, we're going to stay live for the trophy presentation. Your final score, the Suntory Vieira Hawks, 26. Port Orange Hawks, 6. I'd like to thank all the 6U fans and families that I've been able to have accompany me on these broadcasts. And I appreciate all your supports and great comments. You guys have been awesome to me. And hopefully I'll see you all back next year, because I always love So here we go. Suntory Vieira Hawks. Swing and a miss on the water. But absolutely. Thank you all for TJ McMahon waiting for Max DeGraff to come get on the diamond. All right, so. All right, so I'm going to unplug and allow you to listen into the trophy presentation.
There's the runner-up trophy being presented by to Port Orange. Again, the fact they got to a championship game is amazing in itself. And now the championship trophy presented to the Suntree Vieira Hawks. All right, we're going to shut down and get ready for 10U action right here on the Brevard Sports Network between the Satellite Beach Scorpions and the Deltona